All right, we won the roll. Let's play first. Looking for basically just some ramp spells. I don't even care what I have to ramp into. This obviously has no lands. This also has no lands. Did I add lands to my deck? They both had some sick one drops, though. I'd get on the board pretty quick. I'm going to five. Luckily, if he doesn't interfere with us or disrupt us very much, Mold 5 is not the worst, since we only need one. Really? Ah! Did I keep this hand? I have four lands in my deck that don't produce green. I drew two of them. This hand seems really bad. These cards don't do anything if I don't hit a four spirit. All right, we're going to four. Booked. All right. Ooh. I'm gonna put this on top. There's a chance that this is my way to victory. If I can cast that on turn three or four or whatever, and I draw like my Kozilek or something, maybe that's my out. Usually Eureka's not very good when you mold the four and your opponent has eight cards, because your cards have to be so much better than their cards, or they just have to have no permanents in their hand. It's very unlikely for this to work, but on a mold of four, I think I'm willing to take the risk, since I'm not going to win this game very often. Otherwise, let's play this guy. So hopefully he doesn't kill that. He played an island, so that's good for us. I just spilled hot coffee all over myself. I didn't scream, though, so that's good. Alright. Oh, it points out what level it is now. It's kind of cool. Bitter Blossom. Alright. I can handle this. We even get to this. We get to find one more card for our Eureka. Let's put this on the bottom. Alright, get in there, baby. I could level up my guy again, but I think the one damage is probably more relevant since he has a Bitter Blossom in play. Alright. Next turn. We really need to draw a Kozilek. Oh, Terrastodon would be a good one, too. Oh, I like it. I like it. We didn't get there. Well, I'm going to discard at random, so I think it's probably just time to... I just had hope he has nothing. He's got a Bloodline Keeper. Game's probably already over. This is my mold of four. He got lands! All right, Bloodline Keeper lands. Basalt Monolith. All right, he's got no cards in hand. We have a shot. We have a small chance. All right, Umog. Do your thing, buddy. I figured taking one damage was not worth leveling this up. He emptied his hand, and it was three lands and a Basalt Monolith and a Bloodline Keeper. Alright, we take our three. Take that, Hypnotic Spectre. The trick is to mold a four and cast your hand before it's able to attack you. Oh my god, that was a sick draw. Alright, so let's just get in there with this Ulamidzi. I feel like he's gotta block it too, so he's probably gonna lose five permanents here. Bunch of lands. Maybe this fairy. Probably three lands, this fairy, and then block with this. I think. Maybe he's also got the Bloodline Keeper guy he can make. I didn't want to attack here because it's just going to die to this or the 2-2. Waiting. Ulamog is a relatively big game. I mean, Bitter Blossom is also a big game that early. If he didn't have Bitter Blossom, this game would, I think, be over. He'd have three less permanents in play. Well, let's assume two. Let's assume Bitter Blossom is like a Shadow Mage Infiltrator or something. All right, he's making a 2-2. Let's see what he sacrifices. Again, I'm going to avoid tapping this Mana Confluence. All right, sacrificing Vampire, Fairy, two lands. Now he's got a Chump Block. This one goes to six. Alright, I like all that. Play this guy. I get to fight something, so depending on what he leaves back, I can potentially punish him pretty hard here. Forest. Let me read this. Tap on tap wolves you control. Each wolf deals damage to target creature with power. Okay. Let's get rid of one additional permanent. Let's attack with this. I'm just gonna wither him down. Next turn, I get to take out a Bloodline Keeper or a Hypnotic Spectre or something. I just wanted to cost him one permanent there. Like, now, if he sacrifices this and three lands, then he takes 11, goes to 5 with Bitter Blossom in play. He's in a lot of trouble. He's got a Snapcaster Mage. Oh, he's just going to sacrifice. Oh, no, he's going to Chump Block, probably. Again, I think he's going to lose 5 permanents here. He lost Basalt Monolith, land, Snapcaster, and Token. He's going to 5. Or, no, to 6, excuse me. He'll be going to 5 on his turn. Alright. So, our guy's almost a 1-4. So, he could attack freely next turn. Nice! That's how you went on the ball to 4, baby. That Eureka. Yeah, whenever you are really constrained like that... Okay, this guy comes in. I don't think I want the naturalize too, but... Actually, maybe I do. Talonder's so good, I don't want to cut that. Phantom Centaur, he's black, so I don't want to cut that. I have Beast Within as well. Yeah, I think I just want the Reclamation Sage. What am I cutting for it? I could cut a Wood Elf's. Could cut a Plow Under. If his deck's cheap and has Basalt Monolith, it might not be as good. Although this is just such a strong play. It's more of a strong play on the play, though. I guess I can cut it on the draw. I could also cut this, but it's a naturalize, so I want to keep it around. Dark Blast is strong against Snapcaster Mage and Bitter Blossom, but not very good against his flyer or his other flying contingent. Yeah, I think I'm just going to keep this. All right, let's go to game 2.